No doubt that participation in sports has a lot of value for kids.
But youth sports have become much more competitive than they've ever been. Intense training schedules and pressure to win and be the best can cause kids to burn out and get injured at an early age. Dave Knight is the sports performance program manager at UW Health at the American Center. Hi, Dave. We thought it'd be good to have you here with summer sports starting up.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So, it is getting more competitive than ever before, and that's causing a lot of kids to want to specialize
it
in
is.
Sports.
Yeah,
do you recommend that?
You know, youth sports are very competitive, and the challenge is it looks good from the outset to get kids involved really early and get them driven early because their skills do improve. There's something we call the golden age of skill development, which is between the ages of 8 and 12. So those skills introduced then make them look really good. The problem is if we don't set a foundation of athleticism over time, those skills kind of plateau out and they can't continue to grow and get better. So the whole idea of getting kids involved really early, it looks good from the onset, but can be really challenging.
What's too early?
From a specialization standpoint, you know, it's hard to say. I mean, chronological age is a big part, so how old you are from your date of birth, but really we want to look at developmental age. And so what we try to do is hold kids back from specializing in certain sports until maybe after puberty or until their growth plates start to close where they can handle the higher volumes and the higher stresses that are placed on them. So again, it depends on where they are developmentally.
What are some of the risks associated with just focusing on one thing and that's all you do at an early age?
Yeah, so obviously injury is a big risk, right? So if you're a golfer and all you do is swing the golf club that one direction, your body creates this asymmetry and builds this asymmetry that can lead to injuries. Burnout is another big risk when kids get put into a situation where potentially their mom or their dad are putting a lot of investment into them as an athlete. If they start to not succeed, they start to mentally not want to participate anymore, or just the idea of participating a sport 12 months out of a year for a young kid, that's really daunting. And so burning out is a big problem.
So if you just do one sport over and over and over again, you're gonna have problems down the road
potentially
even
sooner than that, right? We have a lot of young kids now who are having these overuse injuries that we just didn't see until they were older. But now we're having 10, 11-year-olds having patellar tendon pain. You know, you hear a lot in the news about how we're seeing more ulnar collateral or Tommy John surgeries in younger kids from throwing too much in baseball. So it's happening a lot more frequently.
Is this a child issue or a parent issue?
Yeah, you know, I think it's a societal issue. You know, we're pushing kids to do more and be better than we were when we were kids. But the problem is that the tide has really changed. When we were kids, we played. We went out,
we
ran
everything.
Around, and we did everything, and we learned for ourselves. Well, now, unfortunately, kids aren't given that opportunity, so we're trying to use what we think is an adult approach on our children, and that's oftentimes not the best.
So do a couple of different things.
Yeah,
different
a few.
Sports. Yep.
Well, I was saying in the break, I saw an interview with Jordan Spieth's mother, the professional golfer, and she said all he ever wanted to do was golf, and she said, absolutely not. You're playing baseball, football, hockey, everything.
I think that's the right approach.
That worked out okay.
Absolutely.
So your advice to parents would be?
You know, when they're young, let them sample. Let them play a lot of different sports. Don't worry about specializing in one sport early. Even if they show talent in that, that's probably even a better reason to get them involved in other things so that their body can round out as an athlete. And then allow them to foster that love of sports. That's really so important, that they have to have that intrinsic drive and love what they're doing in order to keep growing and keep getting better.
And are there resources at UW Health?
Yeah, so we have the sports performance program that I run is really founded in that idea of developing fundamental movement skills and building athletes from the ground up and really trying to have them develop the skills they can use for a lifetime.
Great advice. Thanks for being with us today.
Happy summer. Good to see
you.
We'll be right back.